Hello friends, I am Nayashek from blogdude.com and welcome to another amazing video. In this video, we'll see how to create professional and beautiful looking logos and designs but without using any professional or technical softwares like Photoshop or CorelDRAW. Now we are going to create three different designs or logos in one single video. This is the first one which you see on your screen. This is the second one and this is the third one. Okay, now before proceeding further, make sure you guys subscribe to my channel, and if you have already done that, then make sure to click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. Okay, with that being said, let's get started. So the first thing that we need to do is open a new tab and type in logomaker.com. It's logomaker.com. Alright, now you'll see this screen. Just delete everything and click on next. Now this is the canvas where we'll be creating our logo. Now let's create the first logo, this beautiful logo. Now if you see over here, the first thing is that we have some text over here, okay, and it says sea monkey. So let's type that. So to type a text or to enter a text here, you'll see this T icon. When you hover over this, it says text. Click on that and let's type in sea monkey. Now as you can see over here, the design of the font is different, also the color is different. Here we have used a black color font and the design is totally different, okay. So let's change the color first, let's make it black. So to change the color, you just have to select this thing from here, okay. Here you see the color picker, you can select any color from here. Now I want to select the black color, so I'll take it over here. Now let's change the design or the font, okay. So what you can do is you can click on this. Here you'll get this option. So first we have to select what kind of font do you want. So by default, simple and modern is selected. Now we want something different. So what we'll do is we'll select this one, fun and funky. Okay. Now if you see the fonts over here is totally changed. Okay. Now if you see, this is the Arbiters font which is used, but in this logo we have used this Slacky font. So if you scroll down, you'll see this Slacky font over here. Select this. Now as you can see, this looks exactly the same. Now we can drag it here and there, we can resize it. If you want to make bigger, if you want to increase the size, what you can do, you can hover here at the end and you can, you know, drag it over here like this. You can increase or decrease the size. Okay, so let's make it something like this. Now after this, we have to select this beautiful logo, okay, this beautiful design. So what we can do, here we have the search bar, you can search for anything. So let's search for monkey. Okay, and press enter. Now as you can see, there are hundreds of thousands of designs over here, okay, available. Now when you type in monkey, there are many different icons for monkey, okay, many different icons and logos. You can select any one of these and you can start creating your own design. Now let me select the one that I have selected in the demo website. Okay, I think it is somewhere over here. Let me search for that. Okay, here it is. This is the design that I have used in that video. So let's click on this. Now as you can see, when you click on this, this is how you get. Now let's decrease the size. Okay, let's make it something like this. This is looking much better, or let's increase a bit. Fine. Okay, now we can change the color of this one in the same way. We can just select any color from here and the color will be changed. Now there is a very cool feature over here for some designs. Now first of all, we have to do it, undo it. Okay, so what we can do is we can press Ctrl Z on our keyboard and that thing will be undone. Okay, so this is how it is looking. Now there is a very cool feature in some logos like this one. As you can see, we can select different portion of the logo and we can color it. Now let me explain you by showing it. So from the left hand side, you will see this paint bucket. Click on paint bucket. Now select any color from the color picker. For example, we want something like this. Okay. Now you cannot see the color at present, but suppose I want to color this beard. So I'll select this beard. Now as you can see, the beard is colored. Now if you want to color the hat, we can click on the hat. Now as you can see, the hat is also colored. Now we have this eye patch, you can color this eye patch and so on. Okay, what you can do, you can select different color for different thing. For example, let's select this blue color for eye patch. Now as you can see, the eye patch is blue. Now let's select this green color and let's click on this hat. Now as you can see, the hat is green. Now we don't want to make this thing, so what I'll do, I'll press Ctrl Z. Now I just want to change the beard color, rest everything is looking fine. Now if you see in this logo, there is also a beautiful background given to this logo, and we have some light color and the background is circle and it has an outline. So let's do that, let's see how we can do that. So first, to add that background, there are many different ways. First, what you can do, you can search for another, logo, another design. You can just search for circle. So let's type in circle. Now, as you can see, there are many different circles available. You can select any one of these. For example, let's select this one. You can resize this, then you can, bring it over here. Then we can, make this thing, send this thing back. Now, as you can see, but I don't recommend this one. This is also this almost the same technique, but what I'll do, I'll select this and click on delete. Now, let me show you another way. So what you can do from the left hand side, there are different shapes available. When you hover this shape, you'll see different shapes available. So let's select the first one, the circle one. Now, as you can see, this shape is over here. Now, let's bring it over here and let's increase the size to something like this. Now, if you see over here, the logo is gone back. So, what we can do is we can send this background or send this circle back. So, we can select this circle, right click over here and select this one, send to back. And that thing will be sent to back. Or there is another way to do so. So, let me show you that. Here, if you see under layers, you will see different layers. The first one is circle. So whatever you want to bring at the back, you bring that layer at the bottom. So we want to bring the layer at the back. So we'll select this circle and we'll make it at the bottom. Now, as you can see, this is worked. Now, let me decrease the size of this circle and let's realign it. Okay, looking better. Now, let's change the color of the circle. So it's really easy to do so. We have seen this. Okay, let's select this color and let's select some lighter shade like this. Okay, now we have the circle. Now we want the outline. So again, very simple to do. So here we have the outline option. Click on that and we can select any color. So I'll select some dark color from here and let's increase the size of the outline. Okay, as you can see, when I do this thing, when I increase or decrease this thing, you can see the outline. So I think 7 pixels is looking better and let's change the color to something like this. Okay. Dark brown. This is looking amazing. Now, if you see over here the color, there is some outline to this font as well, to this text as well. So let's do that. Select this text and again select the outline and let's increase or decrease it. As you can see, blue color is selected. So again, we'll select the color of our choice and let's select something like this. Okay, looking better. Let's increase the, okay, so 4 or 5 pixels will be better for this one. Okay, with this we have completed our logo, but the final thing is left, which is to save the logo. So first let's select this thing. What you can do, if you select just one thing and you drag it over here and there, this is how it will do. But what we want to do, we want to select both the logo and the circle and the outline, and we want to do everything at the same time. So what we can do is we can do something like this. It will select both the thing. Now if you drag it here and there, you can select both of these. Okay. Now we want to bring this at the center. Okay, so this is looking better. So once the logo is complete, we have to crop this thing. So at the bottom, you'll see this crop button. Select this and you can select the portion that you want to crop. So let's select this much. All right, so this is looking better. Once you are done, just click on this save logo button. Okay, now select the second option to download it for free. Okay, now as you can see, the logo is successfully downloaded. Now we can just cancel this thing. All right. So this is how you create a simple logo. As you can see, this was such a beautiful and professional looking logo, but we have created this within few seconds or within few minutes, maybe a minute or two. Okay. So this is really amazing. This is really awesome. You know, doing this thing is another kind of fun. Okay. Now let's create the second type of logo, this one. So what I'll do is I'll cut this thing and again, I'll open a new tab and type in logo maker. Let's start from beginning. Okay. Let's cut this thing. Okay. Next. Fine. So let's see. So this is how it looks. Okay. So the first thing here, this is in fact more easier than that one. Okay. Only two things are used over here. You know, you might be seeing and you might be thinking, wow, this logo is really amazing, simple, but nice. But here only two things are used, just this font, this text and a simple logo. Okay. Now let's search for this logo. So let's search for play button. So just type in play over here at the top. Now, as you can see, there are so many results for this play. Now, let us see. I think this is the one which we have used in that logo. So let's select this one. Okay, this is how it will look. You can decrease the size or increase the size according to your need. So let's decrease it a bit. Now, if you see over here in this, the middle play button, that triangle shape is red color. So we know how to do that. It is really simple. We select the paint bucket, we select the color, so we select the red color, and then we select that that part. Okay, so we have selected that part, and as you can see, this is so simple. Now let's add the text. So click on text, and the text is very simple, YouTube. Okay, simple. Now you can change the text. Okay, you can change the font. So by default the railway font is selected, which is a very good font. I think it is really looking better, but you can select some different fonts as well. For example, in the demo one, I think we have used the Oswald. So let's search for, here it is, Oswald. So this is the one which we have used over there. Now we can increase the size, okay, like this. Okay, let's increase it a bit more. Okay, so this is looking better. And let's color it, let's make it red, the same color. Okay, if you select this one, and let's select the red color from here. Okay, a bit lighter. Okay, this is looking better. Now let's drag it over here. Okay, fine. So once you are done, again click on this crop button. Let's select the portion. Okay, all right. Now these kind of logos are very useful for you, you know, for creating these headers when we create different websites and we need a logo in the header. So in the header, these kind of logos are useful, rectangle shape logos. Okay, now make sure, notice one thing, that this is backgroundless. You see the white background, but when you save the file, there won't be any background. So whatever color or whatever design your website is, this logo will be backgroundless. Okay, when you upload this logo on your website or wherever you want to upload it, you'll see what I mean by that. Okay. Okay, so again, once you are done selecting the section to crop, just click on the save button and select the second option to download this for free. Okay. Okay, done. So we have created two different logos within few minutes. Now let's quickly create the third one. This is also very simple. Okay, so it is almost the same thing. So again, what I'll do is I'll just type in logo maker in the same bar, in the same tab, and let's cancel all these things. All right, now this is also very simple. As I said, we have a background, a shape. So let's select the shape, let's select the circle one. Here it is. Let's increase the size a bit. Obviously there are more shapes available. For example, you can select this shape as well. Okay, there are many shapes available, you can select any one of these. So we have the shape, and in that shape we have this simple icon, the crown icon, and we have this king press written. Okay, so let's do that. Let's search for crown. Okay, as you can see, there are many different types of crown available. Now I have used this one, I guess. So click on this and let's bring it over here, and let's change the color to white. Now let's add the simple text and let's type in king press, and again we want to change the color. So we'll first change the font style. So let's select Oswald for this one. Okay, now let's change the color to white. Let's bring it over here. Okay, looking better. Okay, so this is looking awesome. Now if you see over here, I have already also used this one, the square shape. So let's create another one, select this square shape, bring it over here. Now if you want to select only these two things, what you can do, you can select, first click on this crown icon, then press the control button, and then click on the this text. Now both this thing will be selected. Now press control C to copy it. Now press control V to paste it. Okay, now this is copied and pasted. Now if I do this, as you can see, this is dragging. Now we can decrease the size according to our need, and we can, you know, drag it according to our choice, and this is how it is looking. Okay, so as you can see, this is how easy it is to create a beautiful and professional logo using this website. It is totally free. You don't have to spend a single penny over here. So this is it for this video, guys. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. This was a very short, but I guess a very useful video. So if you like this video, make sure to give a thumbs up to this video. Also give a comment, leave a comment. If you have any suggestion, any kind of, you know, request for me, if you have any doubt, leave them in the comment section below. If you like this thing, and if you want to learn more stuff like this, then click on that red subscribe button. Also click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. See you soon.